Hey everyone, welcome back to Generation What? Holiday Edition, because it's almost the holidays. Today we're diving into the generational gift guide. So we're gonna talk about different things that would be appropriate to get that certain member of a generation in your life that you're like, I don't know what anyone that age would like. Here you go. So let's start it off with our youngsters, right? Gen Zers. Gen Zers can be hard to shop for because they're in a world of technology. So it's like, if you can't get them the coolest gadget that's like $700, what do you get them, right? Some suggestions, just kind of going along with the whole climate of Gen Z right now. See what I did there? There's a great book written by climate change activist Greta Thunberg. It's called No One Is Too Small to Make a Difference. It'd be a great way, first of all, to get them off their phones, off their devices, and actually read a book. But also, Greta is obviously a big climate change activist of the Gen Z generation. So it's cool to be inspired by people making a difference of your own age. Another idea, more on the device side, an iPhone holder for your car. I actually have one myself, and I think it is an absolute lifesaver, literally and figuratively. I think it's amazing. It's a great way to really take your phone out of your hands, but also if you need to use the GPS, it can be right there and you can still have your eyes on the road. So great for Gen Zers as they're taking over the roads today and obviously obsessed with their phones. We want to make sure that they're being safe about it. So moving right along to millennials, this generation right here, what do those dang millennials want for the holidays this year? Something that's really big, really hip right now, but also really useful is an activity monitor watch. So not necessarily one of those expensive Fitbits or even an Apple Watch, but there's actually watches you can get that just monitor your activity. And they go for around 20, 30 bucks. So it's pretty affordable. I know a lot of my friends have them and they're always comparing and talking about how many steps and how can we reach our 10,000 steps a day. It keeps you active, especially as we're apparently the least healthy generation out there right now. Also another thought to get millennials off of their devices, there's a book of the month subscription, which is pretty cool. It lets you choose between, I think, 5 or 6 books every month and it sends you those books in the mail. So kind of a cool way to engage your millennials in a different way. All right, Gen X. Gen X is really hard to shop for because they're in the prime of their spending power, ability, income right now. So they have everything, right? For those Gen Xers in your life, something that you could keep in mind, especially since Gen Xers right now, a lot of them have young children, even babies. I'm really all about these subscriptions right now. There's an infant food subscription package. There's also one for seasonal baby wear. So, you know, when the seasons change, you gotta go out and buy all these different clothes for your kids, it actually sends those to you. So it's a cool way to keep your kids looking fresh throughout the seasons. And then something more for the Gen Xer themselves. What's really in right now is like retro gaming systems. I was just at a White Elephant and a Tamagotchi came out, made an appearance. Everyone got super excited about it. These retro gaming systems that are reminiscent of like Nintendo's, Atari's, things that Gen Xers were really growing up with. So kind of fun for Gen Xers. Boomers, our lovely boomers. For that boomer in your life, a really highly suggested gift for boomers, surprisingly, is like a tablet holder or a tablet stand, because a lot of boomers are getting really savvy at these tablets these days. I know my mom uses hers all the time. So getting a cool stand or a holder that can make it easier for them to use that, because a lot of them are ditching, you know, desktop computers in favor of their tablet. So making that easy for them. Something also kind of techie side to bring boomers, you know, up to speed with the whole smart TV situation, maybe getting them a smart TV, a Roku, an Apple TV, because a lot of them do still rely on cable for most of their TV viewing pleasures. So open them up to the world of a smart TV, of Netflix, of subscription services where you can actually access shows at any time. Last but not least, our traditionalists out there, maybe your grandparents, you're trying to figure out a gift to get them. Something super cool for this generation is those digital picture frames. And yes, they might be a little old. My grandparents, we got them one long time ago, but they love it. And it's cool because you can upload different photos and keep them posted on different things that you're doing as they happen. And it doesn't just have to be a singular photo in that frame. They love that. Another great idea is the stones that can go in your cocktails, like whiskey stones that are basically ice, but they don't melt. So it's a great way for our traditionalists when they're drinking their, you know, afternoon whiskey and throw in some of those ice stones and it won't water down their drink at all, especially if they're more of a slower drinker. So there you have it, folks. It's cool to keep in mind people's generations when you're shopping for them because it helps to inform those decisions and figure out what they can actually use, what might be helpful for them, what they might enjoy. Be sure to comment below with your thoughts or a gift that you've gotten this year or some more ideas that maybe this sparked for you. And I'll talk to you next week on Generation What?